Before we get into this top 10, guys, one of the worst things for gamers is being in the middle of an insane gaming session, getting hungry, nothing in the house to eat, and having to stop gaming to leave the house and go get food. And that, my friends, is where Grubhub comes into the picture. Simply go to the site, put in your zip code, and you are gonna see all the restaurants that are available to deliver to your area. I just did it. I had no idea that my favorite hibachi was actually available on Grubhub. And now I have it at my house. I'm about to sit down. I'm about to start a gaming session on my SNES Classic on Legend of Zelda Link to the Past. I don't have to leave the house. I have my food, and it's because of Grubhub. So check it out, guys. Super easy to use, super easy to order. And right now, new members that sign up can get $7 off their first order. There's a link in the description, at the top of the description. Take advantage of it and never be in the middle of a gaming session again and actually have to leave your house to get some grub. I'm sure you guys know how insanely good some people are at video games, and I'm sure you also know how insanely passionate people are about gaming. Well, this mix of skill and passion leads to a super competitive set of world records that are constantly being broken and re-recorded by both players and developers. But there are some long-standing gaming world records that, no matter how hard people try, they'll probably never be broken. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 insane video game records that, in all honesty, will probably never be broken. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Be sure to take advantage of the giveaway, guys. Drop a like on the video, subscribe really quick, and now, let's go over some really, really crazy video game records that how they got there, I don't know, but they'll probably be there to stand the test of time. Kicking off the list at number 10 is the most critically acclaimed fighting game. Now, fighting games are a pretty strange beast. It's difficult to make a fighting game that appeases everyone due to how unique different mechanics are in different fighting game franchises, and also how insanely difficult it is to actually make a balanced fighting game. But according to the records, the most critically acclaimed fighting game of all time is the original Soul Calibur, released in 98 for the Sega Dreamcast, holding an average rating of 98%, which is, that's honestly pretty impressive considering how divisive fighting games can actually be. And it's a shame that we haven't really been hearing much about the Soul Calibur franchise in the recent years, considering this is technically the most critically acclaimed fighting game in video game history. At number 9, the first game to ever have motion capture. I've actually experienced motion capture. I got to go when they were making Infinite Warfare and actually be at a mocap stage and get a mocap suit. It was phenomenal. Many video games use motion capture nowadays, a lot of them actually do, to portray and accurately come off with the characters, their animations, everything. They want it to be as realistic as possible. But when do you think this practice actually started? Maybe the early 90s with Mortal Kombat? Perhaps earlier with Street Fighter 2? Well, the first game to ever make use of motion capture was actually the classic adventure game Prince of Persia, released all the way back in 1989 for the Apple II computer. While many people forget that this was a franchise, the gaming industry definitely owes them a lot of respect for innovating a development tool that would later on, right now, become the standard. At number 8, the longest video game race. Everyone has their own favorite racing game, okay? But how long have you ever played a racing game without getting bored? And there is a UK-based gaming community called Ready Up, and they managed to set the world record for the longest gaming session in a racing game on April 18th of 2009, where they played Burnout Paradise for 24 hours straight. You would think that if you're going to play a racing game for that long, you would at least choose, what, Mario Kart? Nope, they did Burnout. Okay, whatever. You still got to give credit where credit is due, and I would never be able to play Burnout that long. There is a record for everything, and I find that more and more every day. And number 7, the most kills in the game of Quake. When this online multiplayer FPS first came on the scene, it changed everything. It really did. It had awesome visuals, smooth gameplay, addicting maps and guns. It was fast. Quake had it all, and it helped secure the foundation that most modern FPS games that you play today were built upon. But how many kills have you ever dropped in an online shooter? Let me know in the comment section. What is your highest kill total, whether it's Battlefield, Call of Duty, Overwatch, whatever? You guys let me know. And there is a world record for the most kills in Quake, and it's held by Jonathan Fatality Wendell. Fatality, man, that is a name that goes way, way back in gaming, who managed to get 671 kills in under 1 hour of game time in an online multiplayer match. So, next time you drop 50 kills in COD and you think you're all the rage, just keep the number 671 in mind. At number 6, how old do you think the average gamer is? Average pro gamer specifically. 18, 19, maybe 20? Well, I have the youngest pro gamer record for you guys here, and his name is Victor De Leon III. And he doesn't care about ages because he has become the youngest pro gamer of all time at the age of 6. This was in 2004. Known in the gaming world as Lil Poison, Victor first started competing when he was 6 years old and made gaming headlines when he came in second at a Halo 2 free-for-all tournament that had close to 600 competitors. He would then go on to compete in many, many Halo tournaments, as well as a few Call of Duty and UFC events as well. Can you imagine dominating the field at 6 years old? I could just imagine as a parent. I would be so proud. Cracking into the top 5, how about the most successful arcade game? And this one isn't specific to any one player, but rather a whole bunch of players. A lot of us have to wonder how successful arcade machines really are, and I mean, they only take a single quarter at a time, and the actual machines aren't very cheap to produce when regarding how much money they actually take back in. Well, they used to take a quarter at a time, but the most successful coin-operated arcade game of all time is actually NBA Jam, released in 93, and it managed to generate over $1 billion in its first year of circulation. $1 billion in quarters, my friends. That is impressive. Can you imagine? Actually, how many quarters is that? Somebody do the math and let me know in the comment section. Okay, if you've ever seen any videos or articles about Guinness World Records, you know a lot of them are crazy specific. Some even get into the realm of, why would anyone do this or this would be a record? Well, our number 4 spot kind of fits into this category, but it's still pretty cool, so I wanted to mention it. Here we go. You guys remember the game Mario Power Tennis, released for the GameCube in 2004? No? Okay, it's okay. It was a tennis game starring Mario characters and featured a mode called Artist on the Court, where you used your racket to smash paintballs onto a wall. Well, a young man named Guillermo Bertrand, hope I said that right, holds the Guinness World Record for the fastest completion of the Artist on the Court mode. He completed it in 14.1 seconds. So, I know this is a super specific world record, but anything completed in 14.1 seconds in a video game is pretty impressive to me. At number 3, the most acclaimed game of all time. What do you think the most critically acclaimed game of all time is? We talked about Soul Calibur being the most acclaimed fighting game. It's a pretty hard one to narrow down since there's so many games and the word good is so subjective when it comes down to critiquing anything. But when you factor in the scores of professional critics, users, and also take into account the number of reviews certain games get as opposed to others, the most critically acclaimed game of all time, are you ready, is Legend of Zelda. That is right. It was released in 98 for the Nintendo 64 and has a lifetime average review score of 98%. You heard me right. It has an average rating of 98%. You may be thinking, well, you said earlier it was Soul Calibur, but that was a fighting game. Remember that now. This is overall, and this is after thousands of reviews, making the feat even more impressive. I don't know if we're ever going to get a game as universally loved as this one ever again. Here you go. At number 2, most Pokemon stuff. Yes, there is a record for being the world's biggest Pokemon fan, and that title goes to Lisa Courtney, who is a woman from the UK. Over the years, Lisa has expanded her collection to include over 12,000 individual pieces of Pokemon merchandise, including, but not limited to, dolls, games, figures, clothes, you name it, she has it. She also made trips and shipments around the world just to secure every item possible. And that's dedication. That is dedication to your favorite franchise. And finally, at number 1 today, Tetris World High Score. Have you ever played the original Tetris? All the versions of Tetris out there, it's hard to determine which one to use, but for the most world records and events, the NES version from 1988 is the one that is used. Now, if you've ever played that version, you know that the score counter actually maxes out at 999,999, but no one has actually ever made it that far until over 20 years after the game was actually made. And on April 19th, 2009, a young man named Harry Hong managed to become the first person to ever hit the highest possible score in Tetris, locking him into the world records with a perfect score. He reportedly been attempting this for 4 years, which makes it even more impressive. I don't think I could ever attempt and fail at something for 4 years. So that's some insane perseverance. And if you've ever played Tetris and how fast it gets, that's crazy. Hand-eye coordination through the roof. There you go, my friends. Those are 10 insane video game records that will probably never be broken. Let me know some others. Do you hold any world records? Let me know in the comment section. There is a playlist below as well with all the other top 10s. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for a new video. We'll be right back.